So today I am going to cover the second part of this SOA delivery strategies. So in my first part, I have already explained on the top-down strategies used by the developer while developing the web services using SOA delivery strategies. So SOA delivery strategies are again divided into three different strategies: top-down strategy, bottom-up strategy, and agile. Agile is also called as meet-in-middle strategy. So in my part one video, I have covered the top-down strategy. We have already covered that top-down strategy in my previous video. So today I am covering the bottom-up strategies. In bottom-up strategy or bottom-up approach, generally, every strategies are again having some advantages and disadvantages, and based on the given budget and timeline, the developer decides the strategy. So based on the budget and timeline, the developer selects the strategy. If the developer is having sufficient time for development, then top-down approach is mostly preferred. But when the time is less and the requirement is urgent, in that case, the developer may prefer the bottom-up strategy for developing the web services. So first of all, I am covering this bottom-up strategies concept, and then we'll discuss the pros and cons of bottom-up strategy. So as the name suggests, bottom-up strategy. So we solve the smaller problems. We are working on a smaller problem, and that smaller problem is solved in bottom-up strategy. So after solving the smaller problem, then integrate these smaller web services for smaller modules and complete the solution. So this is what the bottom-up approach. So mostly object-oriented languages are again preferred this bottom-up strategy for developing the application. C++, Java, C#, Python, they use this bottom-up strategy for developing the application. So they will get all the object-oriented advantages because of using this bottom-up approach. So redundancy is minimized by using data encapsulation and data hiding. The module must have communication among the different modules. The web service must have communication among different web services to fulfill a business task. So bottom-up approach again supports composition and integration feature. So let us see the example of bottom-up strategy, how the bottom-up strategies are again adopted by the organization while developing the web services in their organization with the help of one calculator web service example. So to develop the calculator service, first that service is again decomposed, and after decomposition we found the smaller piece of that particular service. So the smaller piece is addition. So addition is the one smaller service. So I am developing the addition service first. After addition service is completed, so the service and client application is again completed, then I am switching to the next web service called subtraction web service. And in subtraction web service, I am using the business chain business logic used in the addition web service. So addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. If the basic operations are again completed, then these basic operations are again integrated in a one web service. So this one web service covers all the basic operations of the calculator web service. So in this calculator service, you select the, you pass the number and you select the operation, so it will provide you that particular operation. So basic operation. After basic operation completed, you go for development of advanced operations with the help of web services. And if the when the advanced operations are again completed, then you develop your whole system, that calculator service. So this is the bottom-up approach or bottom-up strategy mostly used by the developer for developing the web services with the help of bottom-up strategy. So bottom-up strategy. So this strategy essentially encourages the user, encourages the organizations. So creation of web services by means of fulfilling the application-centric requirement. If the application is having their the requirement, so based on that application requirement, bottom-up strategies are again preferred by the organization. So these particular strategies are also called as needed strategy. So web services are built on as needed basis. So if you required, if you needed the web services, and if you don't have the sufficient time, you develop the web service with the help of bottom-up strategy. And in IT organization, most of the services are again developed with the help of bottom-up strategy. So it is modeled to encapsulate the application logic. So the web service is developed, then application logic is written, and the developer can write the application logic in their own technology. So you can call the web service with the help of Python, PHP, .NET, or any technology which support the web service client. So they fulfill the intermediate requirement of the solution with the help of bottom-up strategy. So bottom-up strategy, the steps followed by the bottom-up strategies are model the application service. So the service is again developed, and after developing the service, that service is again delivered. The visual is again provided to the end user, and the end user uses that visual document in their client application. And in that client application, they give the reference of the visual, and after providing the reference of the visual, develop the application. As I have said that to develop the application, they may select any technology. So after developing the application, test the service. And after the testing the service, the deploy the service. So these are the five steps preferred in the bottom-up strategy processes. Let us see one by one this bottom-up strategy. And with the help of one example, so see here, I have draw one diagram, and that diagram gives you the idea of bottom-up strategy. And I'm explaining this bottom-up strategy of developing the web services with the help of calculator web service example. So in this bottom-up strategy, whenever you are identifying the web services and client application, here the web service is developed first. In case of top-down approach, web service client application is developed first and then the web service. But in bottom-up strategy, web service is again, this web service is again developed first. So you develop the web service first, you test the web service with the help of different testing tools. So I'm using SOAP UI as a testing tool for testing the web service. And after the web service is successfully tested, then I am writing the code of web service client. So here in bottom-up strategy, only the web service is again developed first, tested, and after testing, the web service client application is developed. So currently, web service client application is not available. So the developer assumes the requirement of the client with the help of the diagram, with the help of analysis model. So with the help of analysis model, the developer assumes the requirement of the client, and based on that requirement, the developer writes the business logic of that web services. So here in bottom-up strategy, I'm developing web service first, testing that web service, and afterward, I'm writing the web service client application. So let us see the web service creation with the help of bottom-up strategy. So I'm using ASP.NET for this bottom-up strategy and for developing the web service. So to develop the web service in ASP.NET, you select the new project, Again, in new project, I am selecting the web application, and in web application, I am selecting ASP.NET empty web application. So you give the name of the web application. Here I have given the name as a addition web service. After empty application is added, then you add the web service. So here I am adding the web service, addition web service. So the name of the web service is given as addservice.asmx. So I am adding the web service logic here with the help of SOAP based service. So the extension of SOAP based service is addservice.asmx. ASMX means it supports the SOAP based service. So see here, I have taken one project, and in that project I have added one web service, and this is the template of the web service. So here in below this web method, the web service logic is again written. So in our case, I am writing the logic of addition web service, and for addition web service, I am passing the two variables, the value of A and value of B. So I am assuming here that the client application is passing the two variables, and based on the two variables, I am adding these two variables, and I am returning the addition of these two variables to the end user. But here the client application is not yet developed. So we are starting from the service application first, and the service I am going to develop first. So you execute the service. So after execution, you will find this particular output when you execute this service in ASP.NET. Also, it provides you the addition method as well as the service description. So this service description I am passing, I am providing to the end user, and for providing the service, secured service description, the service provider may provide the wrapper services. So third party wrapper services are again, secured services are again provided to the end user to use, to access this particular web services. So web service description is again allowed with the help of wrapper services. Secured access is again given so that the end user can access this particular web service securely. So addition web service. To test this web service, just click on add link, add method, pass A and B value, and click on invoke button. So after invoke, you will get the output in XML. So this is the normal way of testing the web services. In some technology, the developer, the service provider is not providing you the GUI for testing the web services. In that case, so see here, the visual document is generated. In that case, if the visual document is again generated, so to test this web service, we can take the help of this visual document. If the service provider is not providing you the testing environment, in that case, there are different testing tools nowadays available. So I am using one of the testing tool called as SOAP UI. So the project name is add service, so addition service, and here I am providing the visual, which is again which is found whenever I am executing the addition web service. So addition web service provide you the visual, so you provide the visual reference here in initial visual. So the project name add service, and initial visual document is again a visual path is again provided. Click on OK. So after providing OK, it will give you the environment for testing this particular web service. So see here. So environment is again provided. So here in the environment, you click on this SOAP request one. Here it will ask you the value of variable A and variable B. So question mark is there. So in that question mark, you provide the value of A and B, because we have not yet developed the client application, and we are testing this particular test with the help of bottom-up approach. So in the bottom-up approach, the web services are again tested with the help of testing tools. So testing tools are again used for testing the web services. In the question mark, I am passing the variable 10 and 20. So after passing the variable 10 and 20, so here in add result, you will find the result. So I am passing 10 and 20, and in the add result, I am getting the result 30. So my web service is running successfully. So now onwards, I am developing the client application. So see here, the process of developing the web service with the help of bottom-up approach. So web service is developed first. That web service is tested with the help of testing tool. And then the client application is written. So see here. So if the web service is again developed, tested, successfully tested, then only I am writing the web service client application. So with the help of bottom-up strategy. So in bottom-up strategy, I am creating the client application in, so I am taking new website, Visual Sharp, ASP.NET MT website. I am selecting the web form, and in that web form, I am designing the web form. I am passing the two variables, two numbers, clicking on add web service, and as soon as the input is given, that particular service provider calls the service, web service, addition web service, and addition web service returns the result, addition result to that particular client application, and that result is again bind with the help of label variable. So see here. So after designing the GUI, providing the reference. So select the client application, right click, add the service reference, and provide the visual reference. Click on go, you will find the addition operation. So we have just created the addition web service because it's a bottom up service. So small modules are again, small services are again individual services created, and then integration of individual service using the bottom up approach. So click on OK. So the service reference is again added in the client application, and then just execute, call the web service with the help of service reference dot add service soap client. So it's a soap service. So soap call is again initiated, and the variable is taken as a service variable. So service dot add A and B. So with the help of this add method, this A and B value is passed to the service with the help of visual document, and the result is written by the service, and the result is stored in one variable called A result, and I am printing that A result, and that A result is again shown with the help of the GUI. So GUI is ready, and our service and client application is again almost developed. So this is the way of developing the using the bottom up strategy of developing the web services. So let us see the steps related with bottom up strategy. So here in developing the bottom up or selecting, choosing this bottom up strategy, note that this process assumes that the business requirement have already been collected and defined. So you are directly writing the bottom up, means selecting this particular bottom up strategy of developing the web services. So business requirements have already been collected and defined. So model required application services. So this test, first steps result in definition of application requirements. So in our case, in calculator addition web service, our application requirement is what? The application is passing the two variables, 10 and 20. And I am calling that addition web service. So it gives you the point-to-point integration channels between the legacy application. So you can develop the web services based on your legacy application, based on your B2B solutions. And after developing the web services, you are providing the secured access with the help of wrapper services. So that wrapper services are again used in second step. So design the required application services. So sometimes the application services model in step one may be delivered by purchasing or leasing the third party wrapper services. Wrapper services means the visual is not given directly to the client application. So they sign one agreement called SLA agreement, service level agreement, and in that SLA agreement, through that SLA agreement, they provide the secure access to the end user with the help of wrapper services. So wrapper services provide secured access. So they may provide the visual and the security key, API key, to the end user to access that visual. So securely accessing the visual, the developer may provide some wrapper services, third party wrapper services to the end user client for accessing the that web services. And these wrapper services, they auto generate the security, means the API keys, through the proxy service. So generally this to enhance the security, wrapper services are again used. So securely accessing the web services. Then the third is develop the required application. So you design the GUI, you after designing the GUI, you call the web service. After calling the web service, you bind your result and display the result. So after displaying the result, the fourth step is stage the service. So you pass the value, you run the service, you pass 10 and 20 values to with the help of that application service. You pass that value, you will get the required result. So you test all the operations. And after successful testing, you deploy the service. So deploy the service into production stage. So this top-down approach and bottom-up approach we have covered. So top-down approach is again having its own advantages and disadvantages. Similarly, bottom-up approach is also having some pros and cons, some advantages and disadvantages. So the majority of organizations that currently building the web services using the bottom-up approach. So see here, the majority of organizations currently building the web services with the help of bottom-up approach. So in IT organization, most of the IT organizations prefer the bottom-up approach as and when need basis. So if the requirement is received, you develop the web service immediately. So it requires less time and budget. If you have sufficient time and budget, you go for top-down approach. So the primary reason is simply add the web service to their existing application. You write the application, add the web service, call the web service, and display the result. So the bottom-up strategy is somewhat the name of this particular strategy is a misnomer. Misnomer means a wrong or inaccurate name is given by the scientist. That bottom-up strategy is a misnomer, a wrong or inaccurate name. So bottom-up strategy is really not at all a strategy at all. It's a way of developing the web service, nor it is a valid approach to achieving the contemporary SOA. So contemporary SOA is achieved only with the help of top-down approach. So bottom-up approach is what? It's a need basis. As and when the need arises, you writing the web services. Very less analysis is again carried out. The time and budget is again very less while developing this bottom-up approach. But most of the IT organization prefer this bottom-up approach for developing the web services quickly. So today I am covering the bottom-up approach. In the next video, I am going to explain you the remaining approach called as agile, meet in the middle approach. And nowadays the organizations may prefer the combination of top down and bottom up. So they have sufficient time, sufficient budget, and as well as the requirement of the organization. So both the objectives are again added, and they prefer the agile methodology, meet in middle methodology. In the next lecture, next video lecture, I am developing I am preparing the video on the agile methodology, agile strategy of developing the web services. Today I am covering this much only.